Former England international Danny Mills is alongside me. Dan, let's have a look at the teams. PSG put the reserves out against Clermont at the weekend. Only Marco Asensio's kept his place tonight. There are three changes, probably more pertinently to the Parisians' last Champions League tie, which was at Real Sociedad last month. Hakimi is suspended. That's a major problem for them. Zaire Emery and Barcola dropped to the bench. So Marquinhos is set to move to right back to make a club record 436 appearance. It's Donnarumma in goal. Marquinhos Hernandez, Lucas Prado and Nuno Mendes. Lee Vitinha and Fabian Ruiz. Dembele, Asensio and 39-goal Kylian Mbappe. What are your thoughts on that PSG side?
Well, the standout players are the front three, aren't they? You know, when you look at it, the goalkeeper's good. We know that. You know, he's a very, very capable goalkeeper. Marquinhos being shipped out to right back would be an interesting one. You know, probably not the most mobile. You know, as it stands, I'm pretty sure Rafinha would be thinking, give me the ball, you know, get at him. Or even Yamal on the other side, thinking, well, you know, maybe he's not as quick as he once was, going to have a go at him. Yeah, I think it's all about PSG's front three. You know, what can they create? What sort of damage can they do? You know, Kubacsia at the back, very 17-year-old at the back in a Champions League game. It's almost unheard of. But I do get a little bit worried, a bit concerned that there are players that are too young. You know, people say, oh, if you're good enough, you're old enough. Not necessarily the case. You know, you need to be a little bit battle hardened at time. You need to have that experience, the game management. I don't see how you have that at 16, 17. You know, to play in the Champions League quarterfinals at that age, I think you need to be a generational talent, off the charts. Rooney, you know, Ronaldo wasn't that good at that age. Messi was, you know, Rooney. So I think it's very, very difficult to throw what our kids in, you know, to an adult game, an adult world, and expect them to perform.
Yep, Kubasi starting tonight. He is less than 3 months past his 17th birthday and becomes the youngest defender to ever start a Champions League quarter-final. Araujo returns to replace Inigo Martinez alongside him. And Frankie de Jong is back from an ankle injury to replace Fermin Lopez in midfield. So it's Ter Stegen in goal. Koundé, Araujo, Kubasi and Cancelo. Gundogan, De Jong and Sergi Roberto, and then 16-year-old Lamine Yamal, Lewandowski and Rafinha. Now, Kev was alluding to the work rate. It's Yamal's 41st game of the season. He's 16.
And that's another point. You know, of course, when you're young, you're fit. You know, it's not so much of a problem. How many great games he had? I don't know. I've not seen him enough to say, you know, if he's had any sort of dips in form or bad games within that. He's clearly a talent, and that's not going to be an issue. But the great managers that we've seen over the years, Ferguson, Arsene Wenger, Guardiola, have drip-fed their players in all the way through. In for a couple of games, out for a couple of games. In for a couple of games, out for a couple of games. Learn your trade, you know, inside out. Just throwing kids in. Alan Hansen was right, by the way. You don't win anything with kids. That Manchester United team that won the title was not a team of kids. There was three or four in there from probably two regular starters, and then one or two come off the bench, you know, from time to time. They had a lot of senior pros and experience within that, and they need that to learn. It's going to be really interesting to watch these very, very young players this evening.
Oh, Barca trying to do it with kids tonight. Well, despite their stature, these two teams have only won one Champions League between them in the last 13 years. A Barcelona triumph in 2015, in which Luis Enrique was the victorious boss, and Xavi made the last of his 767 appearances for the club. Tonight, those two meet again as opposing bosses, hoping to mastermind triumph via the latest instalment of a fixture that's conjured up the implausible over the last decade. Barcelona in their change kit tonight of all yellow with a little bit of red trim. PSG in their very familiar dark blue and in possession with Marquinhos. What a night for him, breaking the long-standing PSG appearance record of Jean-Marc Pilger. He played 435 games for the club, but 436 for Marquinhos tonight, albeit in a slightly unfamiliar position over at right back. His first sortie forward down the far touchline has seen a free kick. One Lee Kang-in and Patinha, the former Wolves man, are the two PSG players standing over this. They're about a yard or so in from the right-hand touchline. Every Barcelona player is back behind the ball. Seven of them in a line, about 15 yards from goal. One in a wall. Loose one inside the penalty area, protecting the near post area. Comes in, looking for a dangerous flick. And he just took a touch on his way through, off Kubasi. Sergio Roberto maybe got the last touch to steer it away for an early PSG corner.
Yeah, interesting set pieces. You know, neither team particularly big in stature. But I wait for this corner, and then we'll talk about what happened just before that last one. Anthony Taylor's just telling players to stop holding. That annoys me so much. Let them hold, and then make a brave decision and give a penalty or a free kick the other way once the ball comes into play. It's always a bit of a cop-out from the referee. He's doing it again now.
Yeah, it is Anthony Taylor who's reffing tonight. Stuart Atwell is the VAR. All English officiating team. Dembélé, well, one of the players that is principally involved in the skirmishing inside the six-yard box. Barca are able to get it away, and Lee will play it all the way back inside his own half, where PSG are going to be able to turn around and bring it forward again with Hernandez.
So just before they created that free kick on the right-hand side, there was a good move down the left for PSG. Obviously Mbappe was looking to run in behind Koundé, and I think it was as Mendes, Nuno Mendes came forward, and he's only 21 by the way, he just brushed Yamal aside, threw him to the ground like a rag doll. And that's about physicality. You can't have that at 16. And sometimes that's the difference. And that's the difference in these really big games.
Fabian Ruiz works it all the way back for his goalkeeper. Donnarumma, another who was playing in the biggest games as a very young man. Milan's first choice goalkeeper from the age of 16. But very much a PSG player now. More than 100 games behind him for the Parisians.
I think the difference is the game is a lot more technical now. You know, there isn't so much of the physicality in terms of, you know, challenges, tackles, heading the ball, that type of thing.
Dembélé trying to make his way through. Joao Cancelo, familiar face, just stood firm, stuck out a right foot, knocks it away from the edge of the penalty area and out of play for a PSG throw. 3.5 minutes in here on TalkSport 2. We'll keep you up to date with all of the goals as they go in from the EFL tonight. Three of the games in the championship, 7:45 kickoffs, they're all 0-0 still, and the other three got underway at 8. We're waiting for the deadlock to be broken in them all. 4 minutes gone, and game we're concentrating on here on TalkSport 2 at the Parc des Princes. Play forward towards Nuno Mendes. Very versatile fullback, can play left or right, playing on the left tonight. And Mbappe's ball inside the penalty area looking for Asensio is cleared. Back it comes from Marquinhos. And towards Dembélé. Dembélé working it inside the penalty area, looking for Lee. But that is cleared. Brought down again towards the edge of the penalty area. PSG with good early possession here. And space over on the left for Nuno Mendes. Barcelona shift across to deny him safe passage down that left-hand touchline. Fabian Ruiz just dropping it off at the feet of Kylian Mbappe. 39 goals in his 40 games this season. Now Mendes in towards Mbappe, trying to improvise. Swift first touch, and then he almost met it with a hitch kick with the outside of his right foot, but he stabbed it wide. Now for a goal kick.
I think Koundé's going to have to really talk to Lamine Yamal on this right-hand side. A couple of times already he's been caught out of position. And again, this is because at the moment, PSG are dominating the ball. How many games this season will Barcelona have played? Oh, is he through here?
Now Barcelona making their way forward towards the edge of the penalty area. And Donnarumma came out and was justified in doing that because he got his hands out of the way as Rafinha was through. And Donnarumma saved with his chest. And two PSG players came back to sweep up behind him.
That wasn't tiki-taka, was it? That was proper old-school Route 1. It's actually meant for Lewandowski, who very, very cleverly left it. PSG defence was all over the shop, and luckily Donnarumma, I thought, was a little bit late coming out, just about got there to stop Rafinha in the end.
I haven't said he cleared it with his chest, seeing the replay, actually, it just died on him, met him at Yorker length, and he got the inside of his ankle to it. That was enough, though. Made sure that the ball didn't hit his hands because he would have been sent off.
But just before that, Jim, I was saying, PSG, I know it's only 5 minutes gone, are dominating. You know, they've got all the possession at the moment. They've got all the attacking prowess. Barcelona don't often have to deal with this.
Now here's Lee with a shot that's taken a little deflection. That's comfortably saved by Ter Stegen. And he'll bowl it out quickly to try and get Lamine Yamal going. And he's been fouled by Fabian Ruiz. Now, a couple of goals elsewhere. Middlesbrough with the first championship goal of the night. Emmanuel Latte-Latte, leading scorer, with his 13th goal of the season. Now, Borough looking for a third straight win tonight, starting 7 points off the playoffs with a game in hand. And they lead at Hull by a goal to nil. And in the other Champions League tie, Atletico Madrid leading Borussia Dortmund 1-0. Rodrigo de Paul has scored that for Atletico, who have been in poor form recently. They've only won 4 of the last 12. Dortmund, on the other hand, just 2 defeats in 17, but a goal down inside 4 minutes at the Metropolitano tonight. We're 7 minutes into this one. It's PSG 0, Barcelona 0. Here's Danny Mills.
Atletico could be dangerous in this half the draw, especially with their defensive record. You know, this is the weaker side of the draw, without a doubt. You know, the Man City, Real Madrid, Arsenal, Bayern is the stronger side. But Atletico, if they made it to a final, I think they're the one team that could spoil the party. You know, that is for sure. And literally, I mean spoil the party.
Yeah, the winners of that game, the Atletico Dortmund tie, take on the winners of this one. PSG against Barcelona. Stegen again. Happy to bash it forward upfield to the halfway line. It'll be returned with a little bit of interest, but he's able to pick it up again. Stegen, who played in the quarterfinals when Barcelona beat PSG in 2015, and also in the 6-1 success, famous 6-1 success in 2017. He's punted it forward here. Barcelona will play a little bit more conservatively out from the back. Then Yamal turning it round the corner. Guy Gundogan will hair after that. It's mopped up effectively enough at the back by Lucas Beraldo. And Donnarumma will get it away. Barcelona winning the second ball. And Lamine Yamal, the 16-year-old, will bring it forward. Slight nick on his ball forward from Vitinha. And Marquinhos will bring it into his stride. Flag stays down for now against Dembele. And Mbappe is sprinting to get up inside the penalty area to offer some support. In the end, all Dembele can do is get a corner out of it.
Surprised the flag didn't go up. It was tight, but I thought he just maybe got a fraction too early within that. But both teams quite early on, unusually, looking to play balls in behind very, very quickly.
Well, what will PSG be able to muster from this corner? Mbappe waiting near the penalty spot. Marquinhos, the captain, stands there as well, hands on hips. There are two right in front of Ter Stegen in the near post area. Now Marquinhos makes a run in towards that near post. It's easily headed away. Vitinha turning. Full 360. And then another one for good measure in the midfield. Getting the better of Yamal. Back for Fabian Ruiz. Now towards halfway. Here's Lucas Beraldo. Vitinha again, turning it forward towards Lee. And the South Korean working it back through the centre circle again. Plenty of players on both sides featuring in a Champions League quarter-final for the first time in their career today. It's almost unthinkable when you consider the run that they both had in the 2010s, that neither of them have been in the last eight of this competition in either of the last 2 years. One of them will be semi-finalists this time around. Here's Dembele against his old club. Pulled back towards Asensio. Onto his left foot. Smart strike, but Ter Stegen just took a step to his right. Got his hands behind him. Was able to beat it into the ground and gather at the second attempt. 0-0.
Barcelona need to get hold of the ball somehow. At the moment, it's all PSG. They're dominating possession, territory. Their press is better at the moment. And Barcelona look a little bit rattled, I would say.
Another goal in the championship. Bristol City leading Blackburn, who are still relegation threatened, by a goal to nil. Top scorer Tommy Conway into double figures for the season now. And Blackburn just 3 points above the bottom three, despite having the division's leading scorer in Sammy Schmodix, who's got 29 to his name this season. But they trail at Ashton Gate by a goal to nil. Middlesbrough leading at Hull. Well, those are the only goals in the EFL tonight. And if you want to hear news of the goals as they go in, then over on Talksport, Adrian in Swansea around the grounds for you. If you've got the Talksport app, you can easily swipe left, swipe right, hear those reports, and also keep abreast of everything that is going on here. Listen to PSG against Barcelona in the Champions League. It's live on Talksport 2 with Village Hotels. Visit villagehotels.com. And we're 11 minutes in. João Cancelo making his way forward. It's in his sixth Champions League quarter-final tonight. And it's the fourth of different club that he's represented in one of them. Ball back through the midfield for the blonde-haired Frankie de Jong. What a boon for Barca to have him back after a month out through injury. He damaged his ankle in a game at Bilbao. Barca have lost possession in the midfield, and a one through ball trying to release Kylian Mbappe up against Araujo onto his right foot. Really good block coming in as Araujo showed him inside, and Koundé was able to step up and just get the block in. But Dembele will bring it forward now. Looping ball, which is deflected. Koundé can volley it away. PSG will regroup on halfway and bring it forward again. They've had much the better of it in these early stages. Now Anthony Taylor's actually going to stop play. He's one of the Barcelona players is down further upfield. Rafinha just got caught, and seeing the replay, maybe just that had his ankle dragged, got caught between the legs of Beraldo. That could be a sore one.
I think it's a foul. But clearly it seems that referees in the Champions League, the directive is to be a little bit more lenient, let the game flow. I've no massive issue with that. He's not injured. He's not going off. He's not even called the trainer on. So I think, you know, there has to be a point where players have to start saying, OK, maybe it was a foul, but I need to get up and play on. If not, you know, my team's going to be a man down. It's a foul. It's a little bit of a trip. You know, nothing more than that.
You saw a lot of Rafinha in his Leeds United days. Are you been impressed with how he's been able to progress at Barca? He's played 80 games for the club now. The goals... He's not been as prolific as he was at Leeds. He's only a 1 in 5 man in his time in Spain.
He's not really kicked on, has he, for the talent that he's got. But again, that I guess that coincides with Barcelona not being amazing, you know, and having to all the problems that they're going through, you know, and the quality in their team has dropped significantly, you know, in the last since three seasons ago.
Yeah, Barca, 8 points off the top of La Liga with 8 games to go. One thing they have gone in their favour tonight, though, potentially, their record against top half opposition in the league this season away from home has been really good. They haven't lost away from home in the league all season. All three of the defeats they have suffered have been at the Camp Nou. Away from home in matches against top half opposition, 4 wins, 3 draws, and three times as many goals as they conceded.
Do you think that's because Xavi understands that this isn't the greatest Barcelona team of all time, and actually going away from home, he realises they've maybe got to be more organised, got to sit in. They can't just go and attack and dominate teams, you know, like we'd expect and like they used to.
Yeah, quite possibly, which you can't do at home when you've got a passionate home crowd.
And even what we're seeing now, they're quite happy to let PSG have the ball, quite happy to sit back and try and stay organised. But of course, that's very, very dangerous when you've got the front three of PSG.
Yes, certainly. It's not functional with a capital F, is it, this Barcelona side? But it's much more functional than just about any other Barca side of the 21st century, I think it's fair to say. But they are still second in the league. As Colin Hatchard, our European expert, was saying earlier, they've been better in Europe this season whilst not being as good domestically. We're on the back foot here. Dembele has won another corner. Kubasi in the right place at the right time, although we really felt that was a stinger as Dembele rifled in a cross which hit him and goes out of play for another corner. Dembele's certainly a player that will feel he's got something to prove tonight. 185 games for Barcelona over his 6 years at the club. 40 goals. He's got just one so far for PSG. As the corner comes in and Ter Stegen is able to comfortably claim it again. Not the best delivery from Lee. Just too close to the goalkeeper. And Ter Stegen bowls it out quickly. And Barca will try and bring it forward. Couldn't they? But he just ran out of room and effectively tapped it straight out of play for a PSG throw. With 15 minutes in, you win Talksport 2. Still PSG 0, Barcelona 0. And largely chanceless through the opening quarter of an hour, Danny Mills.
Yeah, a couple of shots from distance. Mbappe had half a chance going through, cut inside, and his shot was blocked. But it's really been all PSG up to now. no idea what the possession stats are, but I would say it's, you know, 70% plus at the moment. They're on the front foot. They're being more aggressive with their press, with their determination, and putting Barca under some real pressure at times.
Well, unsurprisingly, the great and the good are at the Parc des Princes tonight, watching on. Didier Deschamps. The camera also showed Ronaldinho earlier, who's one of, I think it's 15.
Which one's the great and which one's the good in that then?
Yeah, well, if you ask Ronaldinho, he'll know. He's both. But I think he's one of 15 that's played for both of the clubs. We've talked about Dembele, and you've got the likes of Zlatan as well. And Ronaldinho, another who is in that particular list of some distinction. It's 0-0 though. This one yet to really catch light, although you will always sense it's not too far away. And you're asking about possession. It's just a little bit less than you thought. High 50s for PSG. They've had the 4 attempts so far, but although 2 of them have been on target, there's been very little for Ter Stegen to have to do. Barcelona haven't had a single sight of goal as yet. Just that one route one ball punted down the middle. And Donnarumma did well to come out and deal with that. That's PSG on the front foot here with Vitinha. Good darting run from here. Finding Kylian Mbappe. He's pulled it back towards the edge of the penalty area. Flicked up with the left foot of Lee. And then an acrobatic clearance from Frenkie de Jong cleared his lines. He got it to halfway with an overhead kick. In fact, all the way through for Donnarumma, and PSG will build from the back with Beraldo. He's pulled down there, but they've kept possession and play will go on.
Seems a lot more than 50, though, doesn't it?
Yeah. You
know, it seems very... It's one direction at the moment that the ball is going in. Barcelona just can't. I don't think Barcelona put more than 4 passes together. You know, and that's what's unusual for them. You know, maybe we've been spoiled over the last 20 years. You know, going back even further than that. You know, some of the players that they have 25, 30 years and going back. But it's PSG coming down this left-hand side yet again.
And Nuno Mendes. He's taking on Koundé, and he's beaten in great little nutmeg, and he wasn't quite in a position to get the shot in. Araujo came and threw himself into the line of fire and just picked himself up, feeling the small of his back after making the intervention. It was really good defending from him, not so great from Koundé, and Nuno Mendes clearly feels as though he's got the beating of him.
Mendes is doing a really good job down this left-hand side. Obviously that's where often Mbappe is, you know, at time, and he wants to come inside. But Mendes is getting wide, he's getting in good positions, and he's giving that right-hand side really something to think about. Obviously, they're doubling up on Mbappe at times. That means Yamin Lamal has got to come back and track Nuno Mendes.
Nuno Mendes missed 6 months of the season through injury, so this is only his 4th start of the campaign. Portuguese internationals had a good start to this 4th start. Now, Barcelona will bring it forward here. Lewandowski working it out towards the left-hand side of the penalty area, and the shot is deflected. Rafinha with it, hit Marquinhos, and goes behind for the first Barcelona corner.
And you just feel that at the moment, the way the game's going, is that Barcelona are going to have a moment of magic from one of their stars. It might be Rafinha, it might be Lewandowski. But I don't really see, at the moment, apart from that, maybe a breakaway or a wonder goal, how they're going to score and how they're going to create chances.
Potentially something from a set piece, maybe. We'll find out. Kubasi is involved in the wrestling. The young centre-half's made his way forward. In comes the corner now. Lewandowski with a header, which hit the inside of the post and was cleared off the line. Back they come again with an effort that's deflected into the side netting and out of play for a corner. So close to taking the lead. Was it Lamine Yamal with the effort, the header which came back on the inside of the post? Donnarumma was beaten, and PSG able to whack it away, inches away from going 1-0 down.
I think it might have been Marquinhos that might have scrambled it off the line as well in there. And we'll wait to see a replay. But your crystal ball was brilliant, Jim. You said they might score from a set piece.
Well, they didn't score from the first one. Mendes heads that one away. Vitinha, and then a right-footed effort, just a bouncing ball from Ilkay Gundogan into the side netting. Having another view of it here on the replay is a good right-footed delivery. It's Lewandowski, actually, and Nuno Mendes just got back. Lewandowski doing well, beating Donnarumma to the punch. And Mendes just got back, just down by the side of the post to be able to poke it away.
Poor goalkeeping, though, wasn't it? You know, came for that. Donnarumma's what? 6'4", 6'5"?
Yeah.
with his arms in the air, he must be nearly 8 foot. Got nowhere near it. I mean, it's ridiculous sometimes. You know, if you're coming and you're going to punch the ball and you're jumping probably 9 foot, you know, with your fist in the air, you should be winning that every single time.
Robert Lewandowski has scored in 5 of his last 6 away games. Goals are dried up for him this season. Again, with the caveat, that's by his standards. Only 20 at a rate of 1 every other game, but that is appreciably his worst return at this stage of a season for years. But 33 in all competitions last season. You think what his numbers were for Bayern. 344 goals in 375 games.
Well, you have to look at the Barcelona side.
Yeah,
well, where are the assists coming from? You know, that's one of the biggest problems. When you look at that Bayern side that he was in, he must have been getting 6 or 7 chances a game. You know, they were, even in the Champions League, they were so dominant.
Well, his record in this competition's even better than his domestic record. 48 goals his last 45 Champions League ties. And he'll be frustrated he didn't make that 49 from 46. It was a good header. Cleared away off the line by Nuno Mendes. The closest that either side have come in the first quarter of the game. And that is despite the fact that it has been almost constant PSG pressure. And it's Barcelona that very nearly took the lead. Yamal for Gundogan. Lewandowski laying it off. Sergio Roberto getting involved. Rafinha from distance. And that's a smart save as well. Diving to his left. Donnarumma got a left hand to it and helped it past the post and out of play for a corner.
Decent strike. Was bounced a little bit, but from 25 yards, you'd always expect Donnarumma to save that. Again, they struggled from the last set piece.
Yeah, needs a save for a goalkeeper with the wingspan of Donnarumma. Well, Rafinha will come across to take the corner now. Will Lewandowski be able to steal a march on the defender and be able to attack a delivery in front of Donnarumma again? Rafinha raises his right arm above his head. It's a left-footed in-swinging corner. Didn't have the height. They were looking for an Araujo flick on at the near post that wasn't forthcoming. The ball played down towards Rafinha once more. Coming in off the right-hand touchline. Left-footed in-swinging delivery. Araujo came very close to that. It was just punched away from him. Taken off his head by Donnarumma. And that was better goalkeeping. They'll try again here. Barca with João Cancelo. His ball in was too low. It's easily knocked away on the edge of the D.
Handball.
Well, it looked like handball, didn't it, against Mbappe, and the referee agreed. Belatedly.
No, I think he's given that.
He's given the other way.
I'm not sure. Well, it hits Koundé's arm, doesn't it? I don't know what the referee's given here.
Well, Koundé went down holding his face. The ball appeared to hit his arm.
He's got a broken eyelash.
He's just being helped back to his feet, Koundé, and there's the wryest of wry shakes of the head from Kylian Mbappe, because the free kick has gone against him.
For what? I do not know.
It did look like superior strength and nothing more than that.
I think Mbappe just brushed some sweat from his brow as he ran past him.
But a free kick for Barca, who've been able to break up the play pretty effectively in the last 6 or 7 minutes. Raft of set pieces, come close from scoring from one. Yamal helping the ball inside the penalty area here, not the best defensive header. Might fall for Gundogan on the edge of the penalty area. It's very well recycled back towards Yamal before Fabian Ruiz can clear. Now Tommy Conway's got a second from the penalty spot for Bristol City. They lead Blackburn by 2-0. Conway's got them both. And Swansea lead relegation threat, and Stoke by a 0-1. Liam Cullen has scored that. So the side's fighting relegation. Bad night so far for Stoke and for Blackburn. And Birmingham in a 7:45 kickoff, second bottom, still 0-0 at home to Cardiff. This one in the Champions League with 25 minutes in. PSG 0, Barcelona 0. Still Atletico Madrid leading Dortmund 1-0 in the other Champions League game tonight. And a reminder, if you've got the TalkSport app, you can just alternate between us and TalkSport itself, where Adrian Durham is at the Liberty Stadium tonight, taking around the grounds for news of all the goals the moment they go in. This one, 0-0. Rafinha's in possession, and he's on the left-hand side of the penalty area. And he's pulled it back here towards the edge of the box, and an optimistic shot from distance just whistles way wide. It was a poor attempt from João Cancelo, and out of play for a goal kick.
Are we sure this is Barcelona we're watching? Because they've had a chance so far with a route one, ball from the keeper straight down the middle, a chance from a set piece, or two chances, half chances from set pieces, and they're playing quite long and quite direct at the moment. Certainly not the Barcelona that we're used to, is it?
Well, it has been effective so far, albeit that they haven't been able to get their noses in front. Another goal in the championship of the Hawthorns. West Brom's leading scorer, Brandon Thomas Asante's 12th of the season. The Baggies leading already relegated Rotherham 1-0. And the Albion starting the night 6 points inside the playoff positions. It seems a racing certainty that they will be in the end of season circus. And you can hear every playoff game from every division on the TalkSport network, part of 60 live games that we will be bringing you in the month of May.
That's too easy. One ball cut out, six Barcelona players. It's a little ball into midfield on the half turn.
Fabian Ruiz had all the time in the world to be able to turn, having picked up possessions, played back here towards Vitinha. Referee Taylor takes evasive action. Ball laid back for Marquinhos, Fabian Ruiz to Vitinha again. Now played out towards the right hand side. Won't be many players who played in a Champions League quarter final who've scored a goal against Chorley. But Vitinha has, the one that he managed for Wolves, a spectacular goal in an FA Cup tie that you might remember a few years back. Here's Fabian Ruiz again, 27 minutes gone at 0-0. Dembele stepping around the challenge of Cancelo with ease, and Mbappe, great movement from him. He just dropped off in the penalty area, wanting the pull back. It was red and the ball didn't get there, but Lee wins it back. The South Korean finds Mbappe, who now comes out the right-hand side of the penalty area in possession. Back for Lee. Left-footed effort from him. De Stegen beats that one away at the near post. And Mbappe coming to attack it. It's a challenge from Cancelo.
He's given offside, I think.
But he has given offside against Kylian Mbappe.
That'll be interesting. I mean, Mbappe's feet. So, so quick. He draws in three defenders. And coming back to Lee, has the shot. Yeah, Mbappe is just offside as he goes for the rebound. He gets caught on the ankle again. I think it was Cancelo, wasn't it? Had every right to go for it. You know, there's not a problem with that. But again, it's Mbappe drawing in three players and just popping the ball off very, very quickly. Lee getting the shot away. But I've been impressed with PSG, to be honest. I think they've been aggressive. They've been high tempo. They've been quite physical as well, putting Barcelona under pressure.
0-0 it remains. Now we played just less than half an hour so far. Now more live European football coming up for you tomorrow. Liverpool and West Ham, both in Europa League action. And we've got both games live for you on the TalkSport network. Atalanta, the visitors to Anfield. That's our main game over on TalkSport. West Ham away at Bayer Leverkusen. And that's live from 8 o'clock here on TalkSport 2. So two more live European games for you tomorrow on the TalkSport network. Liverpool, Atalanta on TalkSport. Bayer Leverkusen, West Ham on TalkSport 2. Build-up starts at 7 ahead of an 8 p.m. kickoff in both of those games.
Beraldo just bought a free kick against Lewandowski. They both got up and giggled. Anthony Taylor got sucked in big time there. Lewandowski was closing down. He stopped before he was going to make any sort of challenge. Beraldo just almost just backed into him a little bit and then jumped in the air. Anthony Taylor decides to give the free kick.
Now Beraldo, another one of the youngsters on view tonight. He's only 20. Player that they signed from São Paulo in Brazil in January in a 20 million euro deal. He's actually sent off on his last appearance, which came in the PSG's game at Marseille. He's already got a couple of Brazilian caps to his name. And a bit of canniness as well. Nuno Mendes taking a throw. And he's had it played back to him just on the edge of the penalty area. Vitinha turning and then turning back to open up his body so that the options to his right are playable. Dembele back for Vitinha. Vitinha not too far out the box. Cross which took a deflection. It's headed away by Koundé, but it's not the best header by any stretch of the imagination. Only foul for Nuno Mendes. And Mbappe fashioning a ball. Fabian Ruiz trying to get it back to him, couldn't do so. Gundogan's going to be able to bring it away. And a former Champions League winner with Manchester City plays it forward out towards the left-hand side, but he couldn't find Rafinha. Oh, then Donnarumma's given it away. A scuffed clearance from him, taken on by Lamine Yamal on the right-hand side of the area. Too much on that cross. Gundogan's going to be able to keep it in, but he's way down by the corner flag when he does so. And he just plays it back down the left-hand touchline. There have been a couple of occasions where Donnarumma's kicking's let him down tonight.
No idea what he was thinking in that situation. Even if it's a good pass, his defender's surrounded by three players. What's he going to do with it? Just give it straight back to you? That's sometimes where that's poor decision-making. You're putting players under pressure, even if it's a good pass, for no reason. It wasn't a good pass, and if he'd been clever, could have had a Bruno Fernandes moment. You know, someone hit it first time, and you find yourself 1-0 down.
That was some finish the other day, incidentally, wasn't it, by Bruno Fernandes?
That's a hard skill as well, you know, to know where the goalkeeper is, to execute that, and it just fades and drops into the corner. It was a stunning strike.
Ball played forward here by Araujo. The Uruguayan centre-half has been able to get it down towards Yamal. On the right-hand touchline for Barcelona with 13 minutes from half-time. And the delayed kick-off in the championship. Hull have equalised the home of Middlesbrough. Jaden Philogene. And it's 1-1 in the East Riding between two sides. 10th and 9th side of play, both chasing the playoffs. Hull and Middlesbrough both 7 points off the playoffs at the start of the night. Hull with 2 games in hand and Borough with 1. That's all square again there, 1-1. Here's Yamal. Not too far away from the edge of the penalty area. Back for Koundé. Sergio Roberto, who scored the winner in that most dramatic meeting between these two. Lewandowski, ball inside the penalty area. Clip forward, it's taking a touch off for Marquinhos. And just goes over the line and out of play for another Barcelona corner.
PSG are causing themselves problems at the moment. Defensively, they're all over the shop at times. Now they allowed that one direct ball straight down the middle. Set piece, Donnarumma came out, got nowhere near it. That Marquinhos, you know, and getting in each other's way. Barcelona haven't really created anything, but they've had 3 good chances because of the poor defending of PSG. Penalty check.
Yep, Stuart Atwell's the VAR, and Anthony Taylor is listening to him. But whatever they thought they saw wasn't significant enough to give a penalty. But Anthony Taylor just asking for the corner to be delayed before it was taken. Sure what that would have been for, I must admit. Maybe a handball. In comes the corner. Rafinha trying his luck, and he smacked it straight at Koundé. It was a well-worked corner, played short towards the edge of the penalty area where Rafinha was lurking, and he smacked it viciously towards goal, but it hit his teammate. And now as PSG bring it forward, Barcelona forced to curtail the attack with Sergio Roberto giving away a free kick, and he's the first player to be booked tonight. And as a result, he'll miss the second leg through suspension.
You're right though, Jim. It's a well-worked corner. All the Barcelona players ran into the box, ran towards the goalkeeper. It was pulled back to Rafinha on the edge. Side foot shot, hit his own player, I think, you know, which was unfortunate. But then PSG, very, very sharp to break away. And a good booking, I think, to take for Sergio Roberto. Because if he gets past him, he releases Mbappe, you're in all sorts of bother.
Certainly advantage Atletico Madrid in Spain tonight. They're 2 up now at home to Dortmund with Samuel Lino doubling the lead just after the half-hour mark. Half-time in the EFL, Ipswich hoping to go back to the top of the table. 0-0 with Watford. Bristol City 2, Blackburn 0, a half-time score. League 1, Peterborough lead Port Vale by a goal to nil at half-time. They're 8 points adrift of second place Derby, who are being held 0-0 at Wickham at the interval of that game. 10 minutes to go at half-time in this one. And still PSG 0, Barcelona 0, but increasingly, you're scratching your head and wondering how it's still 0. Here's the young centre-half, Kubasi, who hasn't really been tested so far. Barcelona have had more possession in the last 15 minutes than PSG, and as a result, it's 50-50 over the whole piece now. Dembele, left-footed, trying to work it inside the area for the darting run of Mbappe. Enough yellow shirts back to be able to get in the way. And then a free kick goes Barcelona's way. 3 parts of the way in the PSG half. It was Sergio Roberto threatened to take it quickly. He was never going to take it quickly. He's going to wait for Lewandowski and Co. to get upfield. 35 gone, 0-0.
Yeah, I think sometimes I'd like to see, you know, when players deliberately kick it against somebody else, you know, when they're a yard away. I'd like to see the referee be strong on that and almost give a booking the other way, because
the only reason you're doing that is to try and get a player booked. You know, if they're not, if they can't get out of the way or they're that close, what do you expect them to do?
Did you ever do that?
Stand in front of the way?
No, kick it deliberately out an opponent.
No, I'd have kicked through them.
Here's Yamal playing inside the area. Donnarumma's come to meet it and only tapped it into space. Rafinha is there and he lashes it into the net. No more than Barcelona deserve after an excellent 15-minute spell. And the majority of the Parc des Princes is silenced. Barcelona lead with Rafinha after another goalkeeping error from Donnarumma.
Football's a strange game at times, isn't it? I still think it's against the run of play. I know Barcelona have been a little bit better, like you said, in the last 15 minutes. But again, it's defensive mistakes. It's a simple ball out wide from Lewandowski. And it's not a great cross from Lamine Yamal. Outside the left foot, I think Donnarumma comes out and gets in the way of his defenders. Because he comes out, the defenders think, well, we'll stop. We won't go for it. He gets fingertips on it, pushes it straight to Rafinha, who's then really, he's got an empty net. All he's got to do, and he's very, very clever, he hits it high. So none of the Barcelona players have got a chance, but that's a huge error from Donnarumma. That's the third one already in this game.
Well, Rafinha had to strike it first time. He sat up nicely for him, bounced just in front of him. He was able to loft it. And Beraldo came back, couldn't quite get his head to it to head it over the bar. Although, to be honest, the way that the shot was travelling and the angle he was attacking it, he probably would just have headed it into his own net anyway. Rafinha's goal 8 minutes before the break. It's PSG 0, Barcelona 1.
PSG's defending has been absolutely shocking up to this point. Really poor. I think their attacking play has been reasonable, midfield play has been good, their pressing has been good, but they've had four really bad errors so far that have led to clear-cut Barcelona chances without Barcelona really having to do anything.
Parisians in possession with Marquinhos, back towards halfway. Hernandez, De Beraldo. And he gets it back again. Now Hernandez in his white boots brings it forward a step and plays it forward through the midfield. Lee trying to get it forward towards Asensio, who hasn't seen too much of it tonight. Raujo mops up and Koundé will guide it back to his goalkeeper. De Stegen can take a hurried but measured touch out of the left-hand side of the penalty area before smiting it forward. Now Lewandowski has done really well. Good leading of the line that. Good awareness of who was where behind him. He knocked it back towards Cancelo. Frenkie de Jong's got it. And he angles the pass perfectly into the path of the onrushing Jules Koundé. Koundé to his right-hand side for Lamine Yamal. It's Barcelona hungry for more, having taken the lead through Rafinha. De Jong's got it now. De Jong in the heart of the midfield plays it back. Inside the centre circle to Araujo. And he'll go all the way back to Stegen behind him. 6 to the break. Barcelona leading in Paris. 1-0, here's Danny Mills.
I have to say, from Barcelona, that their game management has been good. They've not overplayed at the back. They've not overplayed in midfield. De Stegen at times has gone route one. He's thought, no, I'm not going to suck PSG onto us. He's just done it again. He's just launched one straight down the middle for Lewandowski, who wins the header. They're playing sensible, direct football, I would say.
Lewandowski with a great flick on there, found Yamal and then chased out of the left-hand side of the box to offer himself for a return ball. Barca recycle it from that left wing, right through central midfield, and down towards Yamal again. 16-year-old with another performance belying his lack of experience at this level. Still only 42 senior games in his career, all but one of those coming this season. Chase after another long to Stegen punt upfield, but can't keep that in. And he goes out of play for a throw that will be taken by PSG. But they've only got themselves to blame for the fact that they find themselves behind.
Yeah, it's been their own, they're making of their own downfall so far. You know, costly mistakes at the back defensively. And another one there, giving the ball away.
And Marquinhos is beaten and Barcelona bring it forward. And there were surely better options for João Cancelo than an optimistic box shot from the edge of the penalty area. Had two in space to his right. Used them as a decoy, went for the near post, got nowhere near getting it right.
He's a better finisher than that as well. You know, that's the sort of finish I'd expected to hit when, you know, you go past one and all of a sudden that you see the goal and you see stars and you see your name in lights and all sorts and then you scuff it. He doesn't normally do that, in fairness to him.
I saw a video of your first career goal today.
Yeah, first and only, really. There wasn't too many after that, Jim. That was the problem.
It's high-quality opposition as well, as I recall. The ball is over on the right-hand side. There are only about 1,700 to see it at Playmore that day, were there? The ball is back with Barral, though.
I'm not sure winning 9-3, I think it was, on aggregate is a huge achievement.
Here's Mbappe. Hey, easy now. Mbappe, right-hand side of the penalty area. Takes it towards the dead ball line. Ball back towards the corner of the box. 3.5 minutes to go to half-time. And Barcelona lead it 1-0. So far, they've been able to keep Kylian Mbappe relatively quiet. Mbappe again now to Lee. Dembele will take it on towards the edge of the penalty area. Can't find a way through. Rafinha wasn't too sure where the ball had gone after it had hit him, but it went to safety from a Barcelona perspective. Cancelo's down by the corner flag. De Jong back to him and he's given it away. Now the ball is played back in behind the advancing Asensio and not with enough legs to be able to get out to the left hand side for Nunes. For Nuno Mendes, I beg your pardon. And then Yamal will be able to bring it forward down the Barcelona right. And he's just been crowded out of possession. It's good defending by Baraldo. And PSG win it back with Fabian Ruiz. But it's error strewn at the moment.
I don't understand it as a defender. You're by the corner flag. And you're playing, that's miles offside.
And Mbappe, no flag has come up against him yet. And a sliding challenge comes in. Mbappe knew he was offside. He didn't try and attack the shot really with any convictions. Probably 2 yards off.
Two? But, and the rest? I mean, when it's that obvious, why do they bother waiting? It's so, so obvious.
Well defended by Kubasi. Who's done all right, the 17-year-old at the heart of the Barcelona defence. Probably stiffer examinations to come tonight than the ones he's had so far. We're 2 minutes from half-time. Now Barca leading, courtesy of that Rafinha goal 6 minutes ago. Here's Mbappe towards the edge of the penalty area. Stabbed away from him, but only as far as Fabian Ruiz. Former Napoli man recycles it out towards Dembele. Lee on his left foot, in-swinging delivery. Araujo heads it away before it finds Kylian Mbappe. But Fabian Ruiz can pick it up, and he's won a throw on the PSG left. Hull 2, Middlesbrough 1 in that delay game. With Jean Serre scoring the goal. I think I'm right in saying that his only previous Hull goal came on his debut for the club and he's not scored in about 70 games since. Hull 2, Middlesbrough 1. Big game down towards the bottom of the National League South tonight. It's 0-0 between Havant and Waterlooville and Welling. Havant in desperate relegation trouble. Welling should be okay. They can get themselves mathematically safe tonight. And the ball is with Lewandowski. Turning in the midfield. And he's done well to drop his shoulder and open up the angle to find Lamine Yamal. Lewandowski making his way forward inside the penalty area. Sergio Roberto chipping it in. Lewandowski with a shot on the turn. Marquinhos was there. The offside flag's up anyway. And it's a free kick to PSG, which they'll take near their penalty spot. Now we're in the last seconds of the scheduled 45 minutes.
I know the likes of, you know, Mourinho, Conte, you know, get an awful lot of stick, you know, at times for the way that they play. But they do teach their players how to defend, you know, individually and collectively. Tonight it's been so error-strewn. And it's also dropping each other, isn't it? You had the issue with Barcelona down their own corner flag. Trying to play a 1-2 a yard from the corner flag, where are you going to go with it? You know, if you roll the ball to me, what can he do with it? Sometimes it's just ridiculous. Yes, you want to play out when you can, but it's about making the right decisions at the right time. Sometimes you have to put your foot through the ball, get it up the other end of the pitch. That's not bad play, that's good defending at times.
Yeah, that was Cancelo and De Jong. They've got 100 international caps between them, more than 750 club games between them as well. Here's Lee coming inside the penalty area now, shifting it from his left foot to his right, swiftly back again. Comes back outside the box because he didn't like the angles that were being created for him. So PSG working that little bit deeper, a couple of steps back to come forward again. Dembele out towards the left. Better ball in this time. It was slid away before Asensio was going to be able to wrap his foot through it. And then De Jong will play it out towards Cancelo and find him effectively on this occasion. Long right-footed ball over the top from the Portuguese. He'll be chased after, and it's a good chase as well. They're inside the penalty area, pulled back by Rafinha to Lamar. And it's a terrible cross back as he looked to try and pick Rafinha out at the far post. And he's hit it three times stronger than he needed to. But it's another really good quick break from Barca. When they get it from back to front quickly, PSG don't have an answer to it.
I think Lamar was trying to bend that in the far corner rather than pick out his Rafinha, who gave him the ball in the first. To be fair, it wasn't a great cross. It was bobbling for him. But Barcelona have done that very, very well. They've been direct at times. They're not afraid from deep in their own half to ping one over the top, not just a punt, but a good pass into space and let their players run onto it, especially Rafinha.
Now, Koundé's been brought down. We're in 2 minutes of added time at the end of the first half, and we've only got a few seconds left. This free kick on halfway is going to be the last action of the opening 45 minutes. Half-time in the first leg about to be blown, with Barcelona having the advantage.
Sign of a good game, Jim, I think. When we're thinking... It's half-time already, and it seems to have gone very, very quickly.
Absolutely. Robert Lewandowski came very close to giving Barcelona the lead. Nuno Mendes denied him with a clearance off the line. Didn't have to wait much longer after that. Donnarumma spilling a cross-come shot, and Rafinha blazed into the empty net. PSG have offered very little going forward. They've only had three shots on target, two of those in the opening 10 minutes. Half-time at the Parc des Princes, Danny. It's PSG 0, Barcelona 1.
Yeah, been impressed with both teams early on. But I think Barcelona, their game management, they've grown into the game. You know, PSG started very, very well on the front foot. High press, aggressive, looking to create chances. Barcelona, they've sat back and they're right, OK, we'll soak up the pressure and we'll hit you with long balls over the top. Very un-Barcelona-like. Certainly not tiki-taka. But it's effective, and I like that. A lot of people criticised Arsenal, you know, when they went to the Etihad and defended deep and they changed the way of playing. No, that's good. That's good tactics. That's adapting to the opposition. Not having the arrogance just to think we can only play one way. So clearly Xavi's looked at it and thought, right, where are PSG's weaknesses? Well, it's obviously long balls over the top, where maybe they go to sleep a little bit, don't switch on, and it's been effective for them.
So what do PSG need to do to be able to counter that? Because it's been a very effective weapon.
Concentrate, you know, first and foremost. Stop making rookie errors at the back. Donnarumma's made three notable errors. He got away with the one from a corner when Mendes cleared it off the line. Where he came for it, got absolutely nowhere near it. He passed it out from the back where, can't remember who it was for Barcelona, if it'd been a slightly more aware first time shot would have put them in trouble. And he comes for the cross, you know. Yamal Lamina puts the ball into the box. It's harmless. It's not a good cross. It's miles away from Lewandowski. But because Donnarumma comes rushing out, trying to almost be the hero, he only gets fingertips on it, palms it for Rafinha, who basically slots it into an empty net. So they've just got to up their game, PSG, defensively. And going forward, they're always going to be a danger.
Well, PSG are unbeaten in 27. But they've got work to do to be able to maintain that record and have a positive result to take to Barcelona with them next Tuesday. Half time here on TalkSport 2. It's PSG 0, Barcelona 1.
Champions League live on TalkSport 2 with Village Hotels. With 33 locations across the UK, Village Hotels have everything under one roof for a great breakaway.
Where would we be without curiosity?
It's the drive that takes us to new places.
It even got us to the moon.
So satisfy your curiosity about electric cars with the Hyundai Explore Electric event, which is on until the 30th of June, where you'll find our award-winning range of electric cars, including the Ioniq 5. Explore more at hyundai.co.uk. It's the dawn of a new Hyundai.
Hi all.
How are we doing?
Afternoon.
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 Let's get this meeting
started.
Hi.
Hi, Mom.
Afternoon.
Where's the tablet gone?
When everyone's home, EE Work Mode prioritizes your broadband for working from home with faster speeds in more places than anyone else. So...
Yeah, I've got you loud and clear. Clear as a bell.
This is broadband made for working from home. Search EE Broadband, powered by BT.
Work Mode with EE Smart Hub Plus. To verify, see ee.co.uk/claims.
Football crazy kids in your life? Lidl can help with that. Do they team talk at meals and know their step over from this scorpion kick? Then this is your chance to win them the ultimate football experience with Lidl Plus. To walk hand in hand onto the pitch with their heroes at UEFA Euro 2024 as part of the Lidl Kids team. Download the Lidl Plus app for a chance to win their dream today. Lidl, we're on your team. End 17th of April, 18 plus, GB residents only, child age 6 to 10, valid passports and Lidl Plus app required. T's and C's apply. See lidl.co.uk/mascots.
Kick off your Sunday morning with a weekend sports breakfast on Talksport with Goals. The free football pullout with the sun. Lace up your boots with the nation's brightest sports breakfast, featuring insider news, big match previews, and expert analysis from Tony Cascarino and Natalie Sawyer.
Oh, it's absolutely magnificent!
Get fully loaded for football with a weekend sports breakfast, Sunday morning from 6 on Talksport with Goals. The essential free football pullout with the sun, every Saturday, Sunday, and Monday.
Talksport 2, official broadcast partner of the Premier League and the English Football League. Thursday night.
And he's gone straight in!
The Europa League live
on Talksport.
And it's an absolute cracker.
Liverpool
versus Atalanta.
Coverage from 7, kickoff 8 p.m.
They've got a goal!
Thursday night.
Continental night kicks
on Talksport.
Talksport Podcast League. Outspoken with White and Jordan.
The best of White and Jordan is now available in one unmissable daily podcast.
So you've got a perfect storm.
From the top flight to the big fight. Get opinionated debate that's always on the ball.
Time to hire somebody who can win.
And on the money.
This is a long way from a done deal.
Outrageous.
Outstanding.
Outspoken.
It's hard to say that, but it's the truth.
Out now.
Listen or download for free on the Talksport app or from your favourite podcast portal.
The Monday Club on TalkSport 2.
A broadcasting juggernaut of sport.
They were in big, big trouble at half-time.
Professional analysis.
He always gets away with these tactical fouls.
Oh, he's the master of the dark arts.
And refreshingly frank opinion after all the action.
I don't know if they're as open as they were and as aggressive as they were.
The Monday Club. The sharpest minds in the business.
Elite level mentality.
Monday afternoon from 5.
On TalkSport 2.
The passion, the pain, and the poetry of the beautiful game.
Overhead kick! Brilliant goal!
The Champions League live on TalkSport 2.
Well, despite their stature, these two teams have only won one Champions League between them in the last 13 years. Ball played down towards Rafinha once more. Coming in off the right-hand touchline. Left footed in, swinging delivery. Araujo came very close to that. She's punched away from him. Taken off his head by Donnarumma. And that was better goalkeeping.
Are we sure this is Barcelona we're watching? They're playing quite long and quite direct at the moment. Certainly not the Barcelona that we're used to, is it?
Volby in the wrestling. The young centre-half's made his way forward. In comes the corner now. Lewandowski with a header. It's in the inside of the post. And was cleared off the line. Back they come again with an effort that's deflected into the side netting and out of play for a corner. Here's Yamal playing inside the area. Donnarumma's come to meet it and only tapped it into space. Rafinha is there and he lashes it into the net. No more than Barcelona deserve after an excellent 15-minute spell. And the majority of the Parc des Princes is silenced. And so that's the situation at half-time in our feature game tonight. PSG trailing Barcelona by a golden nil. We've got the whole of the second half coming up for you on TalkSport 2. Now elsewhere in the Champions League, Atletico Madrid leading Borussia Dortmund by 2-0 at half-time. And Rodrigo de Paul getting them off to the perfect start. Lino making it 2-0 just past the half-hour mark. In the Championship, the 7:45 kickoff, so the second half underway in all of these games. Birmingham 0, Cardiff 0. Bristol City leading Blackburn 2-0. Tommy Conway with both of those goals to take his season's tally to 11. And Ipswich will go top if they win at Portman Road, being held by Watford. That's 0-0 there. The 8 o'clock kickoffs, Hull 2, Middlesbrough 1. Philogene equalising Emmanuel Ladilat's early goal for Borough. And then John Serry giving the Tigers the lead just before half-time. Swansea leading Stoke by a golden nil. And West Brom similarly won up at home to Rotherham with Brandon Thomas Asante's 12th of the season. the difference between the two sides, and that will just about consolidate West Bromwich Albion's playoff place. A couple of games in League One as well. Second place Derby being held at Wickham. Derby 8 points behind Pompey, one clear of Bolton in third, but it's 0-0 their match at Wickham at the moment, whilst Peterborough in fourth lead relegation threatened Port Vale by a golden nil with Randall's goal in first half stoppage time. Two important games for the relegation picture in the National League South tonight, and they're both 0-0 in the early stage of the second half. That's Havant and Waterlooville at home to Welling, and Truro at home to Eastbourne, and controversially the match in the Premiership tonight at Dens Park between Dundee and Rangers is off. Now over on TalkSport, Adrian Durham will keep you up to date with all of the goals as they go in, and reports as well throughout the second half, both domestically and continentally. That's over on TalkSport. We've got the second half of our game coming up for you in about 8-9 minutes time, something like that. And the live European football continues on the TalkSport network this week as well, with two cracking ties in the Europa League tomorrow. We're live at Anfield for Liverpool against Atalanta on TalkSport. And here on TalkSport 2, we're on the road with West Ham as they travel to Germany to face high-flying Bayer Leverkusen. You can certainly expect more European drama on the TalkSport network.
Nunez curls it! What a goal! Darwin Nunez! That's absolutely wonderful!
It's difficult to play against Italian teams, always was.
Atalanta lead after just 11 minutes in Bergamo!
We have to be at our best. Not thinking about the final or something like that. We really have to be at our best.
Patrick Schick has done it again! And Bayer Leverkusen! May have just nicked it again in stoppage time!
He'll drop down to Emerson. Urs to shoot, edge of the D. Does! That's magnificent!
I think it'll be a good test for Alonso's side, because West Ham got some terrific players and they know how to play in Europe.
The drama might not be over yet.
Now, the drama certainly isn't over, and we've got those two games tomorrow and news of Aston Villa in Conference League action as well. Now, every Sunday, as I'm sure you're aware, Trans Euro Express with Danny Kelly's the go-to show on TalkSport for all of the big news from across the continent. And this weekend, Danny was joined by European football expert Kev Hatchard to look ahead to those two Europa League ties in particular.
Yeah, it's been a bad week for them, Danny, because they lost in the Coppa Italia semi-final away at Fiorentina, and that was quite a draining game because there were a ton of fouls in it. It was a real bloodbath actually between them. They really went for it in midfield, so much so that they were having to kind of try and bypass the midfield by the end. And then that clearly took its toll this weekend in Serie A, because they had the lead away at Cagliari and ended up losing the game, and that's damaged their hopes of potentially qualifying for the Champions League. However, that is not to say that Atalanta are not dangerous, because absolutely they are. They have a goalkeeper in Marco Carnesecchi, who's in brilliant form at the moment. He kept the score down in midweek against Fiorentina. And they have Tuun Koopmeiners, who is absolutely brilliant in midfield. A player that's been linked with Liverpool a lot, actually, in the past couple of seasons. Juventus very keen on him. He's been scoring lots of goals. Really lovely technical midfielder. And I really like Ademola Lookman, and have for a long time. And I'm so pleased for him that he's scoring on a regular basis in Serie A and has been for a while. This is a guy that, you know, didn't happen for him at Everton. He had to go away. He went to Leipzig. Did really well when he first got to Leipzig. But then when they signed him permanently, just didn't quite happen for him. Change of coach. And he couldn't quite impress Nagelsmann. So they have dangerous players, but I do think Liverpool over the two legs are the clear favourites, because even though you never want to rule out Gasperini because he's such a tactical genius, I just wonder if a long season with a lot of games is catching up with them.
Yeah, the other tie involving an English club is against Bayer Leverkusen, who, as you point out at the top of the show, are unbeaten in 41 games in all competitions. And they take their form to the London Stadium. And I've got to say, this is by no means a done deal for Leverkusen.
I said at the time this was drawn, I felt that West Ham were a danger to Bayer Leverkusen, and I still think they are. You know, Leverkusen would love to get through the entire season without losing a game, but I think this is a genuine threat. And I think you're absolutely right. if you've got a team that has Lucas Paquetá in it, and it has Mohamed Kudus, and it has Jared Bowen, and it has all that quality, then that's a threat. My question would be, how bold will David Moyes be? Because I think if we see the team that really went for Freiburg in the previous round and absolutely wiped the floor with them, that will cause Leverkusen a problem. I think if he tries to do what sometimes he gets stuck in doing, which is to just be reactive, stay in shape, do all that stuff, I think eventually Leverkusen have too many quality players to pick them off. So I'm not saying you should go toe-to-toe with Leverkusen, because you can't. You'll lose that battle. If it becomes a transitional game, you'll lose it. But they have to show some kind of adventure.
And that's TalkSport's European football expert, Kev Hatchard, looking ahead to the games tomorrow. It's Liverpool against Atalanta, Bayer Leverkusen against West Ham. They both kick off at 8, the first leg of the Europa League quarterfinals, and they're both live on the TalkSport network. The game from Anfield on TalkSport, and West Ham's match in Germany here on TalkSport 2. You won't miss a kick of either game, and the build-up kicks off at 7 on the respective stations. Late goal in the first half, right at the end of first half stoppage time for West Brom. 2-0 at home to Rotherham. It was John Swift that got that second. And the relegated Millers facing another bad night tonight. West Brom, as I mentioned, consolidating their playoff place. Two teams back out at the Parc des Princes for our feature game. Kylian Mbappe stands and looks focused on the job in hand. PSG will still be pretty confident they can come back and turn this around yet, but they trail to Rafinha's goal 8 minutes before half-time. Barcelona in all yellow with the red trim. They're going to be kicking from right to left as we look at it. PSG in all dark blue. That's one last instruction from Xavi towards Rafinha. And when Xavi walks away, Anthony Taylor blows his whistle. We're back underway. I'll run through the two teams for you in a moment. PSG kicking from left to right. And Frenkie de Jong goes down in the midfield. Referee waves him back up again. And Barcelona will work it between the two centre-halves at the back in a bid just to get a little bit of early possession. Araujo down for Kubasi. And he'll play it away towards the right-hand side for Jules Koundé. Alongside me, former England international, Danny Mills. Danny, what are you expecting in the second half that we haven't seen in the first 45 minutes? What are the tactical nuances?
I'm expecting PSG to be a lot better defensively, to shore things up. Always almost a really good ball through there. I think it was Mendes, you know, breaking, coming in from the left-back position, looking to get the ball away. They haven't really got Mbappe into the game too much. I think there's an over-reliance on him at times to do something special, conjure up something out of nothing. So I expect them to be still on the front foot, put Barcelona under pressure, but defensively they've got to be so much better. Donnarumma was poor in that first half. Three glaring errors. One led to a goal, the other two could have easily done. His blushes were spared. When Mendes cleared one off the line, he got fortunate, you know, with a pass out from the back as well. There's not much between these two teams, in all honesty. But if I'm the other teams in... If I'm Atletico, I think they're still 2-0 up at the moment, aren't they? Or if I'm Real Madrid and City, Arsenal and Bayern, I'm sat at home watching this thinking, yeah, have any of these two in the final, without a shadow of a doubt, because we'll blow them away.
Well, both of these teams have struggled in the recent past in this competition. One of them will be in the semi-finals. PSG bringing forward here. Chance for Vitinha. And Stegen knew from a long way out that he was going to be able to watch that one fly over his bar. Barcelona with Stegen in goal. Koundé, Araujo, Kubasi and Cancelo, the back four. Gundogan, De Jong and Sergio Roberto in midfield. Yamal, Lewandowski and Rafinha, the goal scorer, are the front three. PSG have got Donnarumma in goal. Marquinhos, Hernandez, Beraldo and Nuno Mendes, their back four. Lee, Vitinha and Fabian Ruiz. And then Dembele floating around. Asensio and Mbappe are the front three. Here's Lee trying to help the ball forward, but not very effectively. Marquinhos can stabbing into a better area. Dembele operating off the left at the moment, down towards the byline. Mbappe pulling it back. Raujo clears. Dembele again. French to shoot. And then does after he chops it back onto his left foot. Rifles it into the roof of the net. It's taken less than 3 second-half minutes for PSG to find their equaliser. It is a stunning finish from Ousmane Dembele against his old club. It's taken him time to get going as a PSG player. Only one goal for PSG before tonight. That one will mean so much for him and so much for his team. 1-1.
What a strike that is. What a hit. That's about pure power. Mbappe goes down the left-hand side and squirms across pullback that sort of gets half blocked, half cleared. As it comes back, he chops it back onto his left foot and absolutely smashes it into the top near corner. They often say that goalkeepers shouldn't get beaten on their near post, but there's so much power in that. I'm going to guess that's going at 70, 80 miles an hour from probably about 16 yards away. He's got no time to react to that. If he saves that, it's unbelievable. It's off the charts. Dembele is off the floor when he hits it. He generates that much power. It's just a pure strike of sheer force.
Well, he's a player that started both legs for Barcelona against PSG the last time that they met 3 seasons ago. And PSG blew Barca away at the Camp Nou. It's been a much more level contest tonight, but Dembele has levelled it up with a really breathtaking goal. Fine strike. And it keeps up PSG's impressive recent run. They have now scored in 67 of their last 72 Champions League matches. Their last failure is going against Bayern in the round of 16 last season. One apiece.
To be fair, they've all had some forward line, haven't they? when you look back at those 67 games.
Oh, yeah. They've had some players able to contribute without a shadow of a doubt to that. Here's Lee on the right-hand side of the penalty area. Fabian Ruiz cleverly worked it for Vitinha. 2-1. It's 2 in 90 seconds. That was a magnificent passing move. And Vitinha just strode forward and strokes the ball into the bottom left-hand corner. Barcelona ahead at half-time and now trailing just 5 minutes into the second half.
The first was pure power out of the blue. This was a fantastic team goal. Precision passing, great movement. It comes back inside. And Vitinha, he picks the ball up. And it's a great first touch. And it's the young centre-half that doesn't quite read it in time, doesn't get across quick enough. It's a fraction slow to see Vitinha running into the box. And as he slides in, he can't quite get there to block the shot. But it's a magnificent finish. Great, slick, one-touch passing move. Fabulous touch from Vitinha and just slots it into the far corner. Suddenly, in the space of, 6 minutes, PSG go from, what's happened? How is suddenly 1-0 down? Suddenly 2-1 up. And Mbappe hasn't even scored yet.
Dembele on 48. Vitinha, just as the clock ticked to 50. And PSG lead it by 2-1. And now Barca have got their work cut out. They've just got to hang in there. There's half-time team talks go. It's one of Luis Enrique's better ones, you would think. Christensen being sent out to warm up by Barcelona. They're looking for an immediate response of their own. Yamal, Lewandowski, oh! He's got this header all wrong. He was only 8 yards out. He tried to get power and swivel the neck to fire it past Donnarumma. And he's come off the top of his head and gone to safety. And by his standards, that should be 2-2.
Oh, you don't often see Lewandowski do that. He got it completely wrong. Bit of a Toblerone head there, wasn't it?
Now they will come again with João Cancelo on the edge of the penalty area. Right footed very deep and too deep past Donnarumma. And out of play. A glorious opportunity for Lewandowski.
Instead of heading it towards goal, he actually clears it. I mean, he's got that so wrong. So unlike him. He's been feeding off scraps so far, to be fair, but you'd still expect him to do better in that situation.
A couple of goals in the EFL, both from the penalty spot. Peterborough leading Port Vale 2-0. Harrison Burrows, a hero at Wembley at the weekend, has doubled the lead from the spot. And Swansea leads Stoke by 2-0. Matt Grimes from the penalty spot. It's a score that's probably of much greater significance to Stoke than Swansea. And Stevie Schumacher's side trailing again. Really has had his work cut out. It's such a fine job that he did at Plymouth, making the job to Stoke, and he's inherited a difficult situation. Now trailing by 2-0. Still Birmingham, incidentally, second bottom in the Championship, being held at home. It's 0-0 their match against Cardiff, and it's as you were elsewhere. I'll run through all the scores for you in a few moments' time. PSG in possession. Now going back inside their own penalty area for Donnarumma. And the whole ambience at the Parc des Princes seems to have changed now. The songs of relief and joy. But still work to do. Yamar trying to bulldoze his way through. Couldn't get past Fabian Ruiz. Now then Beraldo will go across the cover. As he just pokes the ball down the left-hand touchline. Mendes couldn't keep it in. And it's out of play for a throw that's going to be taken on the Barcelona right by the 16-year-old. Yamal getting it back immediately. Plays it to halfway to Kubasi. And the 17-year-old just working through the centre circle. Rafinha trying to turn it round the corner. Has lost possession. Lee will get it forward very quickly. And they've got a chance to break with a right-footed effort. This deflected and then helped onto the bar. And the substitute, Barcola, with a magnificent effort. As it came onto his right foot and he just chopped inside. Hit a right-footed effort which just looped up. Hit Kubasi, just a faint touch. And then a faint touch as well from the goalkeeper. But it needed the pair of them. And he's come back off the bar and out of play for a corner.
So, so close to making it 3-1. Great counter-attack, great breakaway. I mean, Tsegan did well, actually, because there was a slight touch, slight deflection, as you say, from Kubasi. He kept his eye on it and was able to push it onto the crossbar.
Well, the first corner will be swiftly followed by a second. Luis Enrique, with his piercing green eyes, just surveying everything. Be much, much happier now than he was 6 or 7 minutes ago. Marcola's looked lively as well, since he came on at half-time to replace Asensio. He's got it again here. Young, very direct, versatile forward. Trying a little 1-2 with Fabian Ruiz that didn't come off. Marcola's still only 21. Arrived in a €45 million deal from Lyon. He's just got the one Champions League goal to his name so far, which came in the group against the Real Sociedad. Not in the group, I beg your pardon, in the first knockout tie against Sociedad. They've had a real mixed bag of a Champions League campaign. The PSG, remember, well beaten at Newcastle, and they lost to Milan in the group as well, but they find themselves now in a position of strength in the quarter-final. It's Barcola, level with the edge of the box, plays it back for Lee. Now Fabian Ruiz thinks about a shot and hits at the sliding Araujo. And it'll be chipped away by Sergio Roberto. Danny, you described it perfectly, the second goal, the Vitinha goal. And it was just that half a second hesitation from Kubasi made all the difference, because he saw Vitinha's run, but he didn't quite see it in time. So when he slid in, the ball was past him. Had he gone half a second earlier, it would have come off his toes and gone out of play for a corner. And those are the fine margins. Here's Mbappe now, trying to chop it onto his right foot, and then goes round the side of Araujo and wins the corner.
They are the very fine margins, but at that sort of level, you get caught out. You know, and that's the problem at times. And that's why some of the best defenders that we see are the most experienced. You don't have to be the quickest. It's about reading the game. You know, look at Thiago Silva. Okay, this season hasn't been fantastic. But in general, his ability to read a game is superb. You know, Rio Ferdinand, John Terry, the end of their career, when, you know, they weren't the quickest.
PSG have worked the corner short. And then a raking left-footed cross that came in was just a little bit too high from Lee. They had Marquinhos coming in unmarked at the far post, and a better delivery might have given him a tap-in. as it has gone out of play for a throw. Very significant goal at St Andrews in the EFL, where Birmingham trail Cardiff by a golden nil. Josh Bowler has got that. Blues have lost six of the last nine. Point adrift of safety at the start of the night, but losing their game in hand. Cardiff ahead there.
Which is why you can often get away with very young forward players, because if they don't have a great game, they make a mistake, it's not the end of the world. If that happens at the back, happens in defence, then you're in trouble, you know, and that's the problem. That's why I think, you know, we've often seen defenders at their greatest 28, 29, 30 years old at times, all that experience of just putting yourself in the right position at the right time. Unfortunately, for, you know, you have to learn, but you can't buy that experience anywhere. You've got to live it. You've got to go through a number of years to get that.
And listen, I guess when you are thrown in by necessity at this stage of your career, when you're only 17, to reiterate, he's the youngest defender ever to start Champions League quarter-final tonight. You're only going to be better from the experience, providing you don't get battle-scarred by it, of course, but he's given a decent account of himself. The bottom line is that those fine margins haven't quite been in his favour this evening.
And that's the difference at times. I'm a little bit surprised maybe why Christensen didn't start in this game. And sometimes it's not just about ability. It's about, you know, mental strength, the ability to be able to deal with the occasion in moments like this.
Here's Vitinha, who at the moment is the match winner. Now towards the right-hand side for Leeds. Had a better second half, and he's just thrown himself into Cancelo there, looking for a penalty. He's never going to get that. De Jong down towards Cancelo, through the midfield. Barcelona are able to pick it up. That is a foul. Sergio Roberto has been caught by Fabian Ruiz. Lee looking for that, is that fair to say?
Definitely. Well, you say he's never going to get it, Jim. We've seen some strange ones given this season. I mean, it would have been ridiculous had he have got it.
Yes, it would probably have been a better description. More changes then being made. We've played an hour. Lee's going to come off. And Warren Zaire-Emery is going to come on to replace him. He's another youngster, the youngest ever starter and goal scorer, just 18 years of age. But at 18, this is his 67th senior game. João Félix will come on for Barcelona to replace Lamine Yamal.
I'm not surprised about that one. I mean, I know he's incredibly young, Jim, and there was a little bit of a concern about that, but I think he's looked a little bit out of his depth, and I think he's been targeted by PSG, especially down that left-hand side for Barcelona.
And we're also going to see Pedri come on. Now, Pedri's another player that was playing some pretty big games very, very early in his career and in his life, and to use horse racing parlance, perhaps hasn't trained on as much as some other people would have anticipated.
There aren't many players that do, Jim. When you go back through the ages and look at very young players that start and play a lot of games very, very early on, how many of them really go on to have magnificent careers? Okay, there are a few. There's Rooney, there's Messi. You know, like, they are generational talents in their own right. When you look at Kevin De Bruyne, it didn't happen for him, you know, immediately.
Barcelona playing it forward. Oh, it's a brilliant volley from Rafinha. And they're back on level terms. Another straight ball over the top of the back line. And Rafinha ran onto it and hit a left-footed volley from 10 yards. No chance at all for Donnarumma. He scored twice. Barca have scored twice. That really is out of nothing. An equalising goal, 2-2.
It's a great finish. It's a very, very difficult skill as it comes. It's a straight run, almost a straight ball. And it almost sort of flicks it with the outside of his boot. But yet again, Donnarumma gives the ball away, trying to chip it to I'm not sure who. And it is. It's just a scoop. Chip over the top. Straight ball, straight run. And he hits it sort of almost with the outside of his foot as it's coming down, and it goes into the corner. Not the greatest connection in the world, but it's one of those where if he connects perfectly, he probably hits it straight at Donnarumma. The fact that he doesn't, it skims off the outside of his boot, goes into the corner of the net. And it's a good finish, but again, defensively, shocking from PSG.
A great pass from Pedri as well. He's only been on the field 30 seconds. And an assist to his name. So 2-2. First half, pretty even. Barcelona having a good 15-minute spell in that, in which they took the lead. Second half, it's been one-way traffic, all PSG, and yet Barcelona have got themselves back on terms. So PSG 2, Barcelona 2. And we've seen three goals in the opening 17 minutes of the second half. I don't know, 2-2 and 3-3, the two ties last night. This one 2-2 with barely an hour gone.
Go back to it, Jim. Team that defends the best wins. And this is why Atletico Madrid have got a chance. You don't concede, you've got to score one goal across two legs, two games of football. That's it. You don't need to score five and six goals, you know, to win a tie. And this why Atletico Madrid will always be very, very dangerous in knockout competition, because they do not concede goals.
In the Championship, Bristol City 3, Blackburn 0. Anis Mehmeti has scored the third there for Liam Mannings of Bristol City. Birmingham 0, Cardiff 1. Hull 2, Middlesbrough 1. Ipswich against Watford still 0-0. Swansea leading Stoke by a goal nil. West Brom by 2-0. Sorry, West Brom 2, Rotherham 0. Are those the scores in the Championship? Remember, over on TalkSport right now, we've got the coverage with Adrian Dunham taking you around the grounds with all the goals as they go in. Here on TalkSport 2, you're listening to PSG against Barcelona in the Champions League with Village Hotels. Visit villagehotels.com. Tomorrow night, two more huge games for you as Liverpool host Atalanta and West Ham go to Bayer Leverkusen. The West Ham game here on TalkSport 2. Liverpool against Atalanta over on TalkSport. Build-up starts at 7 ahead of an 8 p.m. kickoff in both games. Now, Vitinha went in high. Both he and the Barcelona player that was coming to meet it, Joao Felix, both went in with boots raised. That was Vitinha that caught his man and has been yellow carded as a result of that. Barcelona have a free kick that they've worked out towards Rafinha on the right wing. 2-2 coming out of the midway stage in the second half here on TalkSport 2. Frankie de Jong's been fouled. It's another free kick to Barcelona, who have really been buoyed by the goal.
Oh, they have. It's been a fascinating game, but a game that's been strewn with little errors all over the pitch. Barcelona giving the ball away. PSG defensively making some terrible mistakes.
Now Joao Felix taking it on towards the left-hand side of the penalty area. A pass that he wasn't necessarily expecting to find its way through, but PSG are going to be able to get that away.
Yeah, well, I said they're going to have to defend better if they're going to win this game. They haven't. Simple as that.
Zaire Emery winning it back from Araujo, and Kubasi is across and he can knock it away. Now Pedri's going to be able to bring it forward. Barcelona number 8 in towards Lewandowski, wearing 9. And now towards the right-hand side for the men in yellow to bring it forward again. Rafinha, who's on a hat-trick, slowing things down, finding Frenkie de Jong. De Jong on the edge of the centre circle. Araujo goes all the way back to his goalkeeper. Just taking a couple of touches, and now we'll just chip it into space. He's got more than 400 Barcelona games behind him now. Andre Ter Stegen, a Champions League winner back in 2015. Bristol City 4, Blackburn 0. Naki Wells with the latest in a long line of penalties tonight. Bristol City 4, Blackburn 0 at Ashton Gate. Another rotten night for Rovers, who still aren't out of trouble after the good start that they made in the Championship this season. 4-0 down tonight. 67 minutes played at the Parc des Princes. PSG 2, Barcelona 2. What do you think PSG will feel that they need to take to the Camp Nou?
Oh, a lead. I would say that the way the game's gone tonight, it's not going to be 0-0 in the Camp Nou either, is it? You know, and that's the problem. That's why I'm looking at the teams, you know, left in the competition. Whoever gets through out of Man City Real will be the favourites, without a doubt. I think Arsenal have got a chance because they can defend. Maybe not great last night, but they've been very, very good all season. But then I'm looking at Atletico. I'm thinking, look at Atletico at the moment, 2-0 up. Can they go the rest of this game in another 90 minutes away from home, keep a clean sheet? Without a doubt. Can any of the others keep a clean sheet for the next game? Probably not, is the answer. And that could well be the difference. That's why I said I think Atletico could well be dangerous, because they're not interested in playing magnificent football. Diego Simeone is interested in winning at all costs, a bit like Mourinho used to be. It doesn't matter how, just win.
Now Rafinha plays the ball through the midfield here for Lewandowski, and there's been a collision between him and Vitinha. Not too far out of the penalty area. Vitinha's already been booked. He'll be spoken to here by Anthony Taylor, but there's no sign that he's going to show him a second yellow card.
Did he touch him?
Well, the replay suggests that Lewandowski's actually tripped himself up there.
That was a very strange... I mean, look, sometimes you do get a weird angle on replays at times. But he looked miles away from Lewandowski then, didn't he?
Yeah. But a free kick has been given.
Well, Rafinha's kissed the ball. I think he might be shooting.
Well, hat-trick at the Parc des Princes. That will be a story.
Often, generally, the giveaway is whoever places the ball is going to take the free kick. You very, very rarely find someone that takes the free kick hasn't placed it themselves. Feel a bit like a golfer. You wouldn't expect the caddy to put the ball on the tee, would you? It's one of those. It's often easier, quite easy for goalkeepers to work out who's going to take it.
Well, this is a long way out, but it hasn't stopped Donnarumma lining up a pretty substantial wall. There are three PSG players. Then Araujo stands as close as he is allowed to get away with by the edge of that wall. Donnarumma's actually asked for a fourth PSG player to go in the wall. So is it going to be Rafinha? You bet it is. Left footed. Oh, it's a good strike. It's saved. Diving away to the right-hand side. He got it past or through the wall. Not too far off the ground. He was actually round the wall. And Donnarumma dived to his right-hand side. He showed him that side of the goal and his handling was good.
Yeah, still a little bit of a spill though, wasn't it? You know, it wasn't the hardest strike in the world. I think he gambled, Rafinha, that Donnarumma thinks he's going to try and flip it over the wall, you know, take a step behind the wall to get there early and just try and roll it in the far corner.
Ball over the top of the other end. It's Barcola. Great sliding chance for Araujo. He was just about to get his right foot behind the ball and send it firing towards De Stegen's goal. And Araujo's coming round the side from nowhere and has slid in and has been able to block it and get it away.
Great saving tackle. He's got his team out of a really difficult situation there. Got his defence out of a real situation. But I'm not sure why he didn't shoot earlier. A great opportunity. He must have known that he was going to get closed down at some stage. Just hesitated before he shot.
Mbappe trying to dart inside the penalty area. Pedri's going to be able to get it away from him, and then Mbappe's fouled. And so Rafinha's on a hat-trick. You know, the last time he even scored twice in a club game was more than 4 years ago for Rennes at home to Nantes. He's done it a couple of times for Brazil since then. He'd also done it for Sporting and a couple of times for Vitória Guimarães. He's never scored a senior hat-trick, and if he could do it in a Champions League quarter-final, way to PSG. Might as well just walk off into the sunset.
It's not a bad start, is it?
Hasn't done it yet, mate. He's scored twice, one in each half. 2-2 the score in the final 20 minutes. Araujo taking a long free kick forward. They were very direct at times in the first half, Barcelona. They haven't been able to quite replicate that in the second period. PSG have been better. Zaire Emery playing it forward, linking up with Barcola. The flag up immediately for what looked like a close offside call. Where's the free kick which will be taken on the Barcelona left? It's 2-2.
You just get the feeling in this game that any team could score at any moment for no real reason, Jim.
Yeah.
So it doesn't have to be a great bit of play. It's like, well, if they get in the final third, they could get a goal almost out of nothing. You know, every time both teams attack, both defences look pretty vulnerable.
Kylian Mbappe on the edge of the penalty area, and he's pulled it back. Vitinha down the left-hand side for Nuno Mendes as Swansea go 3-0 at home to Stoke at the Liberty Stadium. Josh Key has scored the latest for them. Marquinhos playing a right-back down towards the right-hand side here for PSG. Hernandez back for Marquinhos again. Those two have just swapped around for a moment. And now play forward through the midfield to Fabian Ruiz. Marquinhos will take it again. It's a couple of yards inside the centre circle. Down towards the right-hand side for the impressive youngster Barcola. Fabian Ruiz. See what he's trying to do with Mbappe making a run and trying to take Koundé with him. Now Barcelona, having turnover possession, will be able to work it forward. Here comes Rafinha off that right flank, and as he got to the edge of the penalty area, ran out of options pretty quickly. Pedri's done well to get it back to him. Is Rafinha again stabbing into his left, João Félix, and it's a comfortable save for the diving Donnarumma.
Yeah, telegraphed that, didn't he? Really opened his body up. It seems to take an age. Donnarumma clearly knew what he was going to do, and a very, very comfortable save as he tried to bend it in the far post. I just had a quick flick, Jim, on the Atletico stats. 35% possession they had, Atletico. 2-0.
Listen, it's a results business.
And this is my point at times, and this is why people gave Mikel Arteta, you know, a lot of stick when they went to Man City and got what I think is a fantastic result and a fantastic point away from home. And look at them now. You know, that's done in the world at the top of the league. You've got to be able to defend well to win stuff.
Bettina inside the penalty area, and it's hit the post. Dembele coming onto it. Across the face of the goalkeeper, and it's smacked back off the right-hand upright. And to Barcelona safety.
And neither of these teams can defend, which is why they won't win the Champions League. I'm pretty convinced of that. Again, it's far too easy. It's just a straight ball. Slipped in behind. Oh, he's so, so close. He opens his body up inside of his right foot. Doesn't quite get enough bend on it. And it hits the post and goes away to safety.
Yeah, to Stegen. Saw the ball go across him, turned round and looked, but his prayers were answered. So a double change being made here for Barca. And they're going to bring Andres Christensen on in the midfield to replace Frenkie de Jong. And we're also going to see Ferran Torres replace Rafinha. So he's not going to get that first career hat-trick tonight. And he turns away, 15 minutes to go. You've got a look of...
quizzical look, I would
a
say.
Quizzical look, yeah. You're mystified at that, I can tell.
Well, PSG can't defend. He's their most dangerous forward, I would say. I'm not quite sure why you would take him off at this stage of the game. It's not been massively taxing him for him, is it? You could rest him at the weekend and then play him in, you know, next week. You're not going to win the league, Barcelona. Strange decision that, I think.
The ball turned around the corner and Barcelona trying to get it inside the penalty area straight away, and it was Nuno Mendes that came back. He cut out the cross but had to make sure that he got his foot underneath it significantly to fire it over his own bar and make sure that he didn't steer it into the roof of the net. He managed that. It's gone out of play for a corner.
I don't think PSG have ever worked on defending in their life by the looks of it. There was two defenders on the edge of the 18-yard box and the rest are on the halfway line. It's just incredible at times.
2-2 the score, 14 minutes to go. This is Barcelona's first corner of the second half. Ilkay Gundogan takes it into a congested 6-yard box and he's headed in by Christensen. He's been on the field about 30 seconds and Barcelona lead again. This extraordinary topsy-turvy corner final has another twist. There have been some epic games between these two in Champions League history. Here's another. Barcelona led. They went behind. They lead again. PSG 2, Barcelona 3. Andres Christensen, such an occasional goal scorer, nods in with his first touch.
I mean, this game is absolutely bonkers. How can you get a free header 4 yards out? He's just come on the pitch. He's one of their biggest players, one of their best headers. Great substitution from Xavi, by the way, taking Rafinha off for him.
Yeah, you called it.
Yeah, I completely get that decision now. But how can you... Christensen must be Barcelona's biggest player on the pitch. He gets a free header 4 yards out from goal. That's disgraceful defending.
So 13 minutes from time. Barcelona lead it by 3-2.
It's not like Jimmy comes
It's not like the ball is floated into, you know, 8 yards out and he comes powering in, jumps head and shoulders above everybody else. He jumps. Yeah, what is he, 6 foot tall? He jumps and heads the ball about 5 foot because he has to stoop. Because, you know, no one attacks the ball. No one's anywhere near him.
In the EFL, Middlesbrough have equalised at half. Finn Azaz makes it 2-2. And Peterborough going to compound their excellent week. They're 3-0 up at home to relegation-threatened Port Vale. Alex Iacovitti scoring near the end of that. PSG 2, Barcelona 3. Often you'll get games where you can say, well, the better side have won. You can understand how they've gone on to win that. I don't think the better side are going to win this. And that's not to say that Barcelona aren't superior. It just happens to be.
I don't know who the better side is, Jim.
It's just going to be who happens to be ahead after 180 minutes. It could be either of them.
Definitely. They're both as good and as bad as each other at the moment.
Hugely entertaining, mind. There's Barcola.
But there's nothing in between these two teams is that would threaten City or Real Madrid at the moment.
You wouldn't think so.
I mean, even Arsenal or Bayern, all those four teams would be looking at this and thinking, well, if we do get through to the final, it's one of these. Should be comfortable.
Coutinho for Barcola. His ball inside the penalty area and Mbappe takes a touch, which forces him back towards the edge of the penalty area. Fabian Ruiz tried to work it through and he couldn't. And Barcelona will be able to bring it away.
Quiet Mbappe, hasn't he? Hasn't really had too much service.
Good turn in the midfield from Gundogan. João Felix. Now down to the left-hand side for João Cancelo. And Kubasic guides it all the way back for his goalkeeper. And Ter Stegen just goes long. It will roll all the way through to his opposite number, Donnarumma. PSG 2, Barcelona 3 with 10 minutes to go here on TalkSport 2.
5 goals and I think Mbappe's had one shot. That's how quiet he's been, isn't it, you know, in this game.
Well, you'd have got big odds on there being 5 goals and neither Mbappe or Lewandowski scoring.
Although it's not over yet, Jim, we've still got 10 minutes injury time.
Oh, it could be 5-5. The ball not forward towards Lewandowski, it's just bounced off him a little. It could have been so different. Dembele's effort coming back off the face of the post only about 3 minutes before Barcelona took the lead. It could have been 3-2 to PSG. We're in the final 10. It's going to be some second leg next Tuesday.
I'm not a betting man, Jim, but if I was, or if you lend me a quid, I'll put a quid on both teams to score next week
in each half.
Yeah,
I know what you mean. It just doesn't have the feel of being a low scoring second leg, does it? Now, of course, the way goals are inconsequential these days, but nevertheless, excellent second half to this tie in store next Tuesday. Now, Derby have been held at Wickham tonight. It's finished 0-0 there in League One. Derby second, they shave the lead to Portsmouth at the top of the table to 7, and they move 2 points clear of Bolton. Would have expected more tonight, particularly with fourth place Peterborough destined to win. They're 3-0 up late on at home to Port Vale in League One.
Ipswich in the Championship still 0-0, isn't it? Does that put them second? Yeah, it does. Level on points with Leicester.
João Felix making his way forward. It's knocked away from the edge of the penalty area. Ipswich being held by Watford. They're in the third minute of stoppage time in that game.
No one wants to win the Championship, do they, at the moment?
Well, Leicester beaten yesterday. Leeds didn't win. Ipswich being held today. Southampton, who won yesterday, will just be frustrated that they're that little bit too far adrift in fourth.
They're too far. If they win both games in hand, 84, they'd be 3 points behind, wouldn't they, still?
3 behind Leeds, 4 behind Ipswich, yeah.
It's a lot to make. It's a lot to overcome that.
Well, they go to Leeds on the last day, though. So you just never know. Pau Gubasi has picked up a yellow card. Got 8 minutes to go. Gubasi had his left arm around the midriff of Barcola as he tried to run past him and just wrestled him to the ground. Easy decision for Anthony Taylor. Sliding challenge wins the ball back on the Barcelona right. We've got 8 minutes to go. And it's PSG 2, Barcelona 3. No further goals in the Championship. They're in stoppage time. Birmingham 0, Cardiff 1, Bristol City 4, Blackburn 0, Ipswich 0, Watford 0. And into the last 10 minutes in the other three, which more in a moment, Zaire Emery bringing it forward for PSG, Barcola, Fabian Ruiz went past him, Vitinha to Dembele. Now Kylian Mbappe, bottom left-hand corner of the penalty area. Back for Fabian Ruiz. Space for him to line up a shot, really well blocked by Pedri. And it'll come back out for Vitinha again. One of the goal scorers tonight.
Football's changed him. Even Atletico have conceded. They've let me down.
And Sebastian Haller's goal for Dortmund just puts a little bit of jeopardy back in that ahead of the second leg of the Westfalenstadion next Tuesday. 2-1 Atletico lead. That's a goal from Haller with 9 minutes to go. They're a couple of minutes behind this game. Fabian Ruiz, we've got 7 minutes to go here. The ball comes down for Bradley Barcola. Substitute's been lively after coming on to replace Asensio. Now PSG working with Beraldo out towards Kylian Mbappe again. Bristol City have a fifth in stoppage time. Another Naki Wells goal. Blackburn hoping that their season doesn't come down to goal difference because they've had a hiding tonight. 5-0 down at Bristol City. Hull 2, Middlesbrough 2, Swansea 3, Stoke 0, West Brom 2, Rotherham 0 are the other latest in the Championship. They've all got about 7 minutes left as well in those games. It kicked off at 8. This one, similarly, 7 minutes to go. 3-2 to Barcelona. Vitinha played out of the left-hand touchline for PSG. Straight back for Vitinha again. Vitinha to Dembele. Dembele with an exaggerated scoop over the top. Vitinha ran into traffic as he tried to get on the end of it. Actually stood no chance of getting on the end of it because it was over hit. But Vitinha...
I didn't think of a check yet.
Collided with two Barcelona players. Yeah, they are going to check it.
I think
awkward,
it's outside.
Awkward defending from Christensen, wasn't it?
Outside the box, I would say. So I don't think there's anything you can do about that. I think it probably is a foul, but I think it's outside the box, Jim.
Yep, I think, Stuart Atwell, the VAR has concurred with you. And the check is over, but another change is going to be made. Barcelona are going to be bringing Fermin on. Another youngster in their ranks. He's 20. Spanish under 21 international midfielder. He's got 3 goals in his last 6 games, including one at Napoli. And he too is playing his first Champions League quarter final. And he'll come on to replace the 2-time finalist, 1-time winner, Ilkay Gundogan. So Fermin for Gundogan. 5 minutes to go. And a PSG change sees Fabian Ruiz come off and striker Gonzalo Ramos come on.
I was wrong last time. Obviously, Christian came on and scored with his first touch from the corner. But I don't know why you take Gundogan off at this stage of the game. An experienced player that's going to keep hold of the ball for you, that knows how to get through the latter stages of games, is not going to panic. It's not been a particularly taxing game, has it, for him? You know, he's not had to run all over the place. And you're bringing an inexperienced 20-year-old on.
So Gundogan off, Fermin on. Gundogan's expression suggests that he thinks along similar lines to you as he takes his big coat and sits back down. The PSG have got possession on the left touchline, which is the far side as we look at it. They kick it from left to right, still inside their own half, but Marquinhos will bring it forward. Sense that he's been a little bit happier in the second half when he's been playing at centre half and Hernandez outside him. Barcola, after Barca gave it away on the edge of the penalty area, they can now bring it forward. It's been won back by PSG in the midfield. There was a foul. The referee waited to see how things were going to develop. There's no discernible advantage for PSG, so they got a free kick. Barcola's taken it. Poor clearance. Dembele onto his right foot. Mbappe threw himself at it. Couldn't get any touch. And it goes out of play for a goal kick. 3 to go.
I thought Mbappe was going to throw his hand at this, Jim, at one stage. Comes all the way through to Dembele. He thought about it, didn't he? I was right. He definitely sort of... He threw his hand towards it and then thought, oh, no, I better not do that. I might get sent off. Could easily get booked
And he was about 5 yards offside. It would have been some way to go. Although, in fairness, I suppose, the offside flag would have come up against him for interfering with play before he's handled it. Would have been a difficult one for the officials. 3-2, 3 minutes to go. Blackburn have been beaten 5-0 at Bristol City. Birmingham have lost at home to Cardiff, which is a huge blow for their relegation fight. And Ipswich held by improving Watford at Portman Road. So the top of the Championship, Leicester 88, 5 games to go. Ipswich 88, 4 games to go. Leeds 87, 4 games to go.
I think the difference is, Jim, you know, people say, oh, 3-2, it must be a fantastic game of football to watch. It must have been magnificent. Look at the game that was 3-3 last night between City and Real Madrid. That was a fantastic game. That was full of quality. Magnificent goals, fantastic play, team goals. This has been 3-2. I don't think it's been an intriguing game of football, but it's been error-strewn rather than five goals of absolute quality.
And still time for more. Barcelona playing your ball. That was cynical. Now, Christensen picked up a yellow card in the previous phase of play. And now as Barcelona bring the ball forward and get it into PSG territory, Koundé has been blocked off. And another yellow card is shown.
Do you know what, Jim? I think that defending was so poor. I'm not even sure that was deliberate. I think he's just mistimed it really, really badly.
Well, it's Lucas Baraldo who has been cautioned. And Fermin booked as well. I think that might be for a little bit of back chat. Maybe the waving of an imaginary yellow card.
Yeah, I'm not sure you're going to get a sending off on the halfway line for a block. Not sure that's a clear goal scoring opportunity.
No, just whether it was serious foul play. It's just that I think that was their appeal. I agree with you. The yellow card's the right decision. Fermin trying to play it back inside the penalty area. A little bit of pinball. And PSG with more panic-stricken defending.
And give the ball away again.
In the final minute of the 90, is going to be a fair bit to be added on, you would think. It's 3-2 Barcelona. A night where it could have been anything for either side. Ball played inside the box. Little scoop cross from Cancelo is headed away. Vitinha, quick feet from him. Oh, he's done really well to squeeze that between the lines for Zaire Emery. And now they'll get it out towards the right-hand side of the area. Barcola takes over. Dembele was waiting for the ball back. Cancelo is there to sweep up. And he'll get it outside of his own penalty area. And Pedri will help it forward. And then a good turn in the midfield, but a really poor ball back to Pedri. And PSG have got it again. Marquinhos, the skipper who's making a club record 436th appearance for PSG tonight. Will it yet be a positive one, or are they going to lose their first game in 28? Here's Mbappe. They're leaving it really late. 4 minutes of stoppage time. They are to salvage something. Their only defeat in the last 33 was at Milan in the group. But is that long unbeaten streak since way before Christmas going to come to an end? Barcelona got 3.5 minutes to hold on to a 3-2 lead. Ball is cleared at the heart of his own defence by Kubasi. Just got it out of harm's way. Baraldo there at the back to sweep up for PSG. He'll turn it forward and the Parisians will come again.
I think what you can say about Barcelona and the difference between... let's get this attack wrong.
Ball inside the area. Christensen can easily get it away.
The Barcelona that I started watching as a commentator and obviously after I finished my career, Sergio Busquets was just one of the best ever, without a shadow of a doubt. I think Barcelona have given the ball away more tonight than he did in his career. I mean, what is it? It's something ridiculous, isn't it? But it's probably about right.
Yeah. It hasn't been a performance between a vintage PSG and a vintage Barcelona.
Yeah, I haven't watched much of Barcelona this season. I've watched the odd game, you know, the Clasicos, etc. But Barcelona, it's not the Barcelona that I expect.
Marcola tries to deliver across the PSG from the left flank. That's blocked. It comes back out for Vitinha. We've got 2.5 minutes of stoppage time to go. Both of those important games in the National League South have ended 0-0. Ball over the top. Oh, that was risky from Araujo as Gonzalo Ramos made the run past him and Araujo just engaged and made a little bit of contact. Ramos certainly made the most of it. And Anthony Taylor tells them all to get on with it. 2 minutes left. PSG 2, Barcelona 3 here on TalkSport 2.
Lewandowski, no real chances, is he? That one header that he got completely wrong. Mbappe.
Dembele. And then a shot from distance which took a little nick on its way through. And that goes out of play for a corner. He had that early header cleared off the line by Nuno Mendes. And then he had the...
But again, that was a mistake, wasn't it? From Donnarumma.
And he had the clearer header that he made a mess of.
But equally, Mbappe hasn't really had... I mean, that's a... shot from distance, not really what you call a chance, is it?
And then a really poor corner. fired in by Dembele and straight into the hands of Ter Stegen. That effort from Kylian Mbappe from the edge of the D, hitting Araujo. I was going to say they've done an effective job at keeping him quiet tonight. I don't know that they have particularly. It's just nothing's fallen his way. Maybe more by luck than judgment.
He's not really been given the ball a lot either, has he?
Ferran Torres back for Lewandowski. We're in the last minute of stoppage time. Barcelona have got it in the PSG penalty area. Cross comes in. It's too hot for everybody. Be picked up on the Barcelona left-hand side. And a sliding challenge puts it out of play for a throw off Pedri. Now PSG will get it forward as quickly as they can. Can they mount one last attack? It's a really poor pass. Gonzalo Ramos with a layoff in the midfield straight to Lewandowski. And Barcelona can get their foot back on the ball. Lewandowski to Koundé. Telling Lewandowski to turn. And the Polish striker does exactly that.
Clever from Lewandowski. He knows. He'll take 3-2. He's not desperate to score himself. He's not desperate to get the ball forward. He's, no, let's just keep it. See the game out. Take a lead back to the camp now.
So Barcelona just maintained possession. They've gone all the way back for Ter Stegen. He will now go all the way forward again. We've got just seconds left. Ball headed away through the centre circle, and that's that. It's a massive win for Barcelona. Not a vintage performance by any stretch of the imagination, but as results go, it's enormous. They're the first side to beat PSG in 28 games, and they've somehow managed to fashion a 3-2 lead coming from behind against Luis Enrique's champions elect. Barcelona, not at their best, but they took the lead through Rafinha. They were 2-1 down with two quick goals at the start of the second half, but then came back with Rafinha again and Christensen with his first touch, heading in a corner to make it 3-2. And Barcelona, a little improbably, have got a first leg lead to defend at the Camp Nou next week. PSG 2, Barcelona 3.
Luis Enrique looks perplexed at the end of that game. No idea how his team have managed to concede three goals. The simple reason is they can't defend. Their defending was really, really poor throughout the night. They started well enough. I thought they started on the front foot. They got themselves a lead. But then defensively, they were all over the shop. I mean, this tie could go either way. Barcelona, slight favourites, you'd have to say, because they're at home. In the second leg, but again, it was littered with mistakes in both sides, all over the pitch. Intriguing, fascinating, not a game of huge quality, but there are certainly going to be goals in the second leg.
Well, Barcelona delighted, PSG fans stunned really by what they've seen. Haven't been too many teams that have been able to come to the Parc des Princes and offer any kind of defensive examination. Nice are the only side that have won on this ground all season in 21 games, but Barcelona have done it tonight. And just, you know, the risk of labouring the point, they've done it without being sparkling, well, without defending pretty well themselves in an error-strewn game.
They've scored three goals away from home in the Parc des Princes, and they haven't really had to do anything for that. You know, realistically, straight ball over the top, you know, and an outside the foot finish, is a sort of a volley, goes into the corner. Donnarumma obviously made a mistake for the first goal, or third goal. How you allow Barcelona's biggest player a free header from 4 yards out from a corner, I have absolutely no idea. So yeah, Barcelona haven't played particularly well, but they scored three goals, you know, simple as that. And that's, a lot of that is down to PSG's poor defending.
Well, Xavi, as a Barcelona player, won this competition four times. He did announce in January that he's going to be leaving in the summer. Recent form has improved, and there's been a sense that potentially there could be a U-turn, maybe. I wonder whether tonight will make any difference. He'll certainly be confident from what he's seen tonight that his side, at least they're going to be able to score one against PSG, and from that point of view might be able to stop PSG scoring two. in the second leg, but we'll find out together next Tuesday. It's going to be another intriguing night of Champions League football on the TalkSport Network.